Welcome you all in this video lecture series on chapter breaks. Up till now we have seen all the theoretical parts regarding these breaks. We have seen the two video lectures on problems on single block break and double block break. Now this is the third video lecture on problems on break, and in this video we will see the problems on simple band break, and in next video we will see the problems on differential band break. So before starting, we will see first the formulas regarding the simple band break, or the theoretical part previously we have studied in different videos, that you can check the all videos because these are the basics and must needed to solve the problem. So these links will be given in the description box, please check that videos first. Now for solving the problems, you must know one formula of the breaking torque for the single band break, and that is breaking torque is equal to breaking force into radius, and breaking force is nothing but value of T1 minus T2, whereas T1 and T2 are the tension in tight slide of the band and tension in the slack side of the band that we have seen. Now the formula for breaking torque, if we are considering the thickness of the band, if thickness of the band is given in the problem, then you have to use the second formula of breaking torque, that is TB is equal to T1 minus T2 into RE. Now in this formula, RE value can be found by R plus T by 2, whereas T is thickness of the band if it is given in the problem. RE value you can easily find, but the question is of T1 and T2 values. To find out these T1 and T2, that is tension in tight side and tension in slack side value, you have to use the two formulas or two relations. That is, first relation is limiting ratio of the tensions, and it is given by T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. In some books, this relation can be given in terms of log also, that is nothing but 2.3 log T1 upon T2 is equal to mu theta. We are using this first relation, that is T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. And the second relation, that you have to find out by taking the moment at fulcrum point. And for taking the moment at fulcrum point, you are having two conditions, that is if rotor or your shaft is rotating in clockwise direction, and if it is rotating in anticlockwise direction, your drum is rotating in clockwise or anticlockwise direction. So first we have seen, if it is rotating in clockwise direction, then the T1 tension will be towards the side wherever the band is connected to B point, and T2 tension will be the slack side and it is connected to fulcrum point. Vice versa, if the rotor is rotating in anticlockwise direction, T1 tension, tight tension, will be towards the O point, that is towards the fulcrum point, and T2 slack will be the towards B point. These two things you need to be considered while solving the problems. It is must. Next, you have to take the moment at fulcrum. So you need to draw the, or you need to know the free body diagram for this diagram. So free body diagram can be drawn easily, and you need not to draw it in the problems while solving the problems. Just in your mind, understand this free body diagram. It is only shown from the diagram given in the problem. So in this, if you take the moment at O, there will be T2 tension passing through O point. Therefore, it will not be in the equation. Therefore, T1 is rotating in clockwise direction. It will create a clockwise direction couple about point O. That's why clockwise direction couples we have considered as a negative sign. P force is in upward direction. It is creating an anticlockwise couple about point O. That's why it will give sign as a positive. Secondly, for anticlockwise rotation, free body diagram will be like this. T1 tension will be towards the fulcrum point. This we have studied. Now, the T1 tension will be zero. It will create a couple zero because it is passing through O point. And equation after taking moment at O point will be minus T2 into B, because T2 is creating a clockwise couple about point O, plus P into L, because P is creating an anticlockwise couple about point O. Like this, you have to calculate the moment about a fulcrum point in the problems also. So if you know these, how to take the moments, and in that equation of moments you are getting value of T1 and T2 if it is clockwise and anticlockwise respectively, and you know the formula of one relation, that is T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. If you know these two relations, you can find the value of T1 and T2 and you can put these values in the equation of braking torque. Braking torque is equal to T1 minus T2 into Re, that you already seen. Now, one more relation you can have, that is T1 is equal to sigma into W into T. If in problem, permissible tensile stress for the material, width of the band and thickness of that band, if it is given in the problem, you can find the maximum tension of the band, that is T1 value, by the formula sigma into W into T. So remember this formula. In some problems, if sigma is given, you can calculate the value of T1 by this formula also. Now, if you know all the theory and formulas regarding this band break, we will solve the first problem now. The simple band break as shown in the figure is applied to the shaft carrying the flywheel of mass 400 kg. And the radius of gyration of flywheel is 450 mm and runs at 300 rpm. Now we will write the given data, mass as 400 kg, radius of gyration as 450 mm, that is 0.45 meter, and the coefficient of friction is 0.2, that means mu is given, and one more term is given, it runs at 300 rpm, that means n is given. From that you can easily find out omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. Next, and the load is 100 newton, that means load is 100 newton, that means you have been given with force applied at point C, at lever C. Then we'll start with the first problem. The simple band break as shown in the figure is applied to a shaft carrying a flywheel of mass 400 kg. So given thing is m is equal to 400 kg. The radius of gyration of flywheel is 450 mm. Radius of gyration k is given as 450 mm, that is 0.45 meter, and it runs at 300 rpm. That means speed is given n 300 rpm, converted into omega immediately. If it is further required, it will be helpful. Omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So if the coefficient of friction is 0.2, that is mu is given here, and the brake drum diameter is 240 mm, brake drum diameter is given, converted into radius, because radius is required to us, radius will be 0.12 meter. Find the torque applied due to the hand load of 100 newton, that means load given at the lever end C is equal to 100 newton. This is our P value. Next, what width of the steel band of 2.5 mm thickness is required for this break if the maximum tensile stress is not to exceed 50 newton per mm square. That means here the width of the band is asked to find if the thickness of the band is given as a 2.5 mm, T is equal to 2.5 mm and sigma is equal to 15 newton per mm square is given to us. Now this is given data. You can find out here the angle of lap, that is wherever the band is wrapped along the wheels, that you can find out by the using diagram. It is not given the theory description of problem. It is can be seen from the diagram as it is equal to 360 degree minus 90 plus 60, that is 150. So 360 minus 150 you will get 210 degree as angle of wrap, and it is in terms of radian equal to 3.66 radian. So it need to be first calculated the angle of wrap if it is not given in the problem. Next, so firstly we have to ask to find out the value of braking torque, and that can be found by the formula TB is equal to T1 minus T2 into R. If the thickness of band is given in the problem, you can use the value of Re instead of R. So here, whenever you are finding that first thing, that thickness of band is not given, therefore we will use directly the value of R here. So in this, T1 and T2 are unknown, that you can find out by the relation T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. Put the value of, sorry, here question mark is there, that question mark is nothing but T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. Mu value is 0.2 into theta value is 3.66, and you will get this ratio of T1 and T2 is equal to 2.08. It is the ratio T1 upon T2 you have got. Now one more relation between T1 and T2 you can find by the taking moment at fulcrum point O. So how to take the moment at point O? For that free body diagram I have shown here, in that free body diagram T1 force, T2 force and 100 Newton force, which is force applied at the lever end, are known to us now. Now by taking moment at point O, T1 is passing through fulcrum point, therefore it will not be in the moment. So T2 is creating one anticlockwise couple, that's why it is having plus sign. T2 into 120 minus P is creating one clockwise couple, that's why it will be having minus sign. P into distance is 300. By rearranging the terms, you will get the value of T2 as T2 is equals to 250 Newton. Now here T2 value you have got, and in above equation you know the T1 upon T2 value is 2.08. So by putting this value of T2 in that equation, you will get the value of T1 as 520 Newton. So you know now T1 and T2 values. You can put the values of T1 and T2 in torque applied formula, braking torque formula. You will get the value of TB as 32.4 Newton meter. This is the first thing we need to calculate. We have calculated the braking torque. Secondly, in this problem is asked the width of the band W. Now for calculating width of band, we have one formula that the maximum tension in band T1 can be given as sigma into W into T, whereas sigma is the maximum permissible tensile stress given in the band, W is width of the band, and T is the thickness of band. Put the values of T1, sigma and thickness, you will get the value of W as width of band 4.16 mm. This is the second thing asked in this problem. So if you know the formulas and how to take the moment, easily you can find the required answer. So second problem we will solve now. A band brake acts on the 3/4 of circumference of the drum of 450 mm diameter, which is keyed to the shaft. Now here it is given that the diameter of the drum is 450 mm, convert the diameter into radius. The band brake provides the braking torque of 225 Newton meter. That means braking torque is given directly in the problem. Full stop. One end of the band is attached to the fulcrum pin of the lever and other end to the pin 100 mm from the fulcrum. Now here the band is, one end of the band is attached to fulcrum O and another end is attached to lever at point B. And it is said that the distance OB is 100 mm from the fulcrum point. If the operating force is applied at 500 Newton meter from the fulcrum, that means O to C distance is given as 500 mm. And the coefficient of friction is 0.25, mu is given. Find the operating force when the drum rotates in anticlockwise direction and clockwise direction. That means you have been asked to find value of P if drum is rotating in anticlockwise direction, and secondly if it is rotating in clockwise direction. What is the difference in this problem? Braking torque is given to you and force applied P you need to calculate here for the two cases. First case, you need to consider the rotation of drum in anticlockwise direction. Secondly, you have to consider it in clockwise direction. So angle of wrap you can find out here. If it is not given here, it is not given in the problem. It is given one in terms of relation, that is 3/4 of the circumference of drum. So circumference of drum is nothing but 360 degree, and 3/4 of it is equal to 270 degree. Therefore theta is equal to 270 degree. In terms of radian, multiplied by pi by 180, you will get 4.713 radian. This is the angle of wrap. This is the first step you need to calculate. Secondly, first we will find out the operating force when the drum is rotating in anticlockwise direction. So in that diagram, observe that the drum rotation is in anticlockwise direction, then T1 tension will be the tight tension in the band wherever it is connected to fulcrum point, and T2 tension is tension in slack side wherever it is connected to lever end at point B. This is the requirement when you are considering the clockwise and anticlockwise rotations of the drum. So for anticlockwise, this is the consideration, that T1 and T2 tension side and slack side. So you need to calculate the operating force, but for that we know one relation of T1 and T2. Use that relation to find the ratio of T1 and T2. So by putting the values of mu and theta, you will get the value of T1 upon T2 is equal to 3.253. This is equation 1 we will consider. And secondly, we know that braking torque TB is equal to T1 minus T2 into R, whereas TB is given to you, it is 1000 Newton, and R is also given to you, TB is given to you 225 Newton, and R is given to you, that is radius of drum, as 0.225. Therefore, you will get the value of T1 minus T2 as 1000 Newton, and you can write as T1 is equal to 1000 plus T2 as a second equation. Now put the value of T1 in terms of T2 in equation 1, and by solving this equation 1 and 2, you will get the value of T1 and T2. These values of T1 will be 1444 and T2 will be 444. So after knowing the values of T1 and T2, you can take the moment about point O, that is fulcrum point O. You will get the equation as minus T2 into B plus P into L, because T2 is creating one clockwise couple, it will be having minus sign. T1 is passing through the fulcrum point, therefore it will not be having any couple. P is creating one anticlockwise couple, therefore it is having positive sign. So in this equation, put the values as L is equal to 0.5, T2 is equal to 444, and B is equal to 0.1. Distance B is given as 0.1 meter. You will get the value of P is equal to 44.4 meter. You will get the value of P equal to 88.8 Newton. So this is our required answer, that is operating force when the drum is rotating in anticlockwise direction. So how we have found? First, we have used the equation T1 upon T2. In that T1 and T2 relation you have got. Again, using the braking torque equation, because braking torque is given to you, you have found one more equation, and by solving these two equations, you have got the value of T1 and T2. You have put these values of T1, T2 in the equation of moment. In the equation of moment, only T2 is present, because T1 is passing through fulcrum only. Therefore, you have got the force P after taking moment. So this is a procedure. Now, secondly, we need to find the operating force when the drum is rotating in clockwise direction. So procedure is similar. You have to find out T1 and T2 by using these two relation. Not necessary to repeat the calculation. We know the T1 and T2 values now, but just these T1 and T2 values will interchange in the diagram, because drum is rotating in anticlockwise direction. In that case, T2 will be the tension in slack side at the fulcrum side, whereas T1 will be the tension in the tight side at the lever side, that is towards the B point. So this diagram will only change, the values will remain same. So after taking moment at point O, T2 is passing through fulcrum, therefore it will not be in the equation of moment. Therefore T1 is creating one clockwise couple, it will have minus sign. Minus T1 into B plus P into L. Plus why? Because P is creating one anticlockwise couple, therefore plus sign. Rearrange the terms and put the values of VL, T1 and B, you will get the value of P as 288.8 Newton. So this is the second problem we have solved. Now third problem, this you have to solve at home and write the answer in comment box. I will read the problem for you. A simple band break is operated by the lever of length 500 mm. Length of the lever is given, and the brake drum has a diameter of 500 mm. Convert this diameter into radius, and the brake band embraces 5/8 of the circumference. That means angle of lap you have to calculate by using this 5/8 of circumference formula. Therefore theta is equal to 5/8 of 360. You calculate in terms of degree and convert it in terms of radius, radian then. So next, one end of this band is attached to the fulcrum of the lever and another end is attached to the pin on the lever 100 mm from the fulcrum. Therefore that distance B is given. Full stop. If the effort applied to the end of the lever is 2 kN, force applied is given as 2 kN and the coefficient of friction is 0.25, the maximum braking torque on the drum. So here you have to find out just a braking torque applied, which is having formula T1 minus T2 into R. So in that only you need to find out the T1 and T2. Now here rotation of the drum is not given. So in that case you can consider either clockwise rotation of the drum or anti-clockwise rotation of the drum and solve the problem. So how was the video? Write in the comment box, and thanks for watching. Subscribe to this channel if you are new. Thanks very much.